The focus of this tutorial is on scanned images. Specifically, we'll go over some recommended practices for creating scans of your photos and what you can do with scans once opened in PaintShop Pro. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you can find a link in the description below that will take you to this tutorial page in Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also find a written version of this tutorial. Scanning options naturally depend on your specific scanner, but most scanners have the same basic output options. Here are the settings for my Canon scanner. When I'm doing a photo scan, I scan in full color at a resolution of 300 dpi, and my output is a TIFF file. TIFF is an uncompressed format that provides the best quality, but produces large files. I could also choose JPEG or PNG, both of which do use compression and result in lower file sizes. PNG supports transparency, which can be nice, for example, if you want to place the image over a different background. And if I choose JPEG, I can choose from three different levels of quality. But you can't go wrong with TIFF. You may be tempted to use black and white or grayscale when scanning old photos. But keep in mind that most plugins are designed to work with color images, except for those plugins designed specifically for black and white. There's really no need to scan in anything but full color, since the resulting scan will still look just like the original, and you can always adjust the level of color later. My settings also allow me to choose the application that will open scanned photos, and I have that set, of course, as PaintShop Pro. For this example, I've created and saved a US letter-sized scan of three photos. This scan was saved as a single TIFF file. In PaintShop Pro, I can use File Open to bring in this image. You can also drag and drop right from your file browser, or drag a file up from the organizer. Another way to open a scanned photo, without having to create the scan and save it first, is to import directly from your scanner. This is done using File, Import, from Scanner or Camera. PaintShop Pro links to my scanner, and I can click here to adjust settings. Here I would choose 300 dpi, and color is my only option. Using this interface saves you the intermediate step of saving a scan first and then opening it. Here are my three scanned images. This black and white one looks good, but this one here is upside down, and this one is a bit crooked. It's easy to make errors like this when placing photos face down on scanner glass. I want to create a separate image file for each of these photos. The best tool for this is the crop tool. The default crop size is freeform, which means that I can set any size I want by dragging from corner to corner. If I click Apply, the rest of the image is cropped out, leaving just the photo. So I'll press Ctrl-Z to undo, and I still have my cropping rectangle where it was before. This time I'll click Crop as New Image, which produces a new file for just this photo. Because my images are displayed as tab documents, I can easily go back to my original scan and keep cropping. For my next photo, I'll switch to 5x7 and use this rotation handle to flip the scan upside down. Now I can adjust the correctly sized crop rectangle and crop again to a new image. Here's a quick tip. If you're using a tool such as the crop tool and want to know more about it, just go to Palettes, Learning Center, or press the F10 key. This will open the Learning Center in your workspace and give you more details about whatever tool you're working with. The Discovery Center also has additional tutorials that go in depth on the crop tool and all of its features. Back to my scan, I'll flip it right side up again and clear the crop rectangle. Now I'll tackle the crooked photo. The Straighten tool is what I want to use now. What appears is a straight line which I can use to set a horizontal or vertical reference line in my photo. I'll drag the endpoints of this line to line up with what should be the left edge of the photo. Then just click Apply in the property bar, and the entire scan straightens relative to this photo. Now I can crop, still using 5x7, and I'll click Apply since I don't need the entire scan anymore. For each of these images, I would use File, Save As, then decide what to do with these new scanned images. This brings us to the end of this tutorial on scanned photos. To see other PaintShop Pro tools in action, check out our Discovery Center at learn.corel.com. And if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of this tutorial to follow along and find many other helpful tutorials for Corel PaintShop Pro.